How are you guys today? It's been a minute since I recorded. I've been editing and posting old footage, but I haven't recorded anything. It was dark. I haven't recorded anything in a minute. Today's Friday. The kids are at school. We're expecting a snowstorm today, so they said it's supposed to start around 2, between 2 and 7. We're supposed to get between 2 to 8 inches. I feel like that's a big window. Like, is it 2 inches or 8 inches? But, yeah, so we might get the kids early from school. I don't know. We might just thug it out and just let them come home at their regular time. But a few schools in the area has early dismissal. Some schools are closed. Both Jordan and Blake school is on regular timing. So we'll see. We're supposed to have a date night later, but I'm not a fan of driving in the snow, especially when I don't have to. So we might postpone date night. Only thing is, Lando's friend is having a birthday party, which obviously that's not gonna be postponed. So we might miss out on that, but we'll see how we feel later. Depends on the weather. Ameer is upstairs in our bed watching my iPad. Yoshi is right here. He needs to go outside. He likes to cuddle with my feet. My feet need to be done. I was supposed to go do that today too, but again, I'm not a fan of driving in the snow. So unless I go do that now, that won't be done. My nails need to be done. My toes need to be done. Yeah, so Ameer is upstairs watching the iPad. I just came from downstairs putting a load of laundry in. I'm about to take Yoshi outside. Then I'm going to go back upstairs with Ameer, finish up some laundry. These braids need to be taken out, but we're not about to do that yet either. So, yeah, that's what's going on with us. So I guess I'll pick back up later, maybe when it starts snowing or something exciting happens. We'll see.
You know, her name is Jade, but I'm just sending you her contact information.
We'll be right back. Good morning. My name is Brittany Covington. My friends call me B. Born and raised in Detroit, Michigan. I spent a little time in Kentucky when I attended college there at Kentucky State University. I am currently a suicide and crisis prevention specialist for Common Ground Midnight Shift, so I'm fresh off work here. Fun fact, I too am a self-published author. My book came out in 2021, and I'm currently working on my second book. And I came to the positive thinking training because why not? You know, never hurts to get more certifications, especially when it's something as positive as, you know, positive thinking training. And three positive things about myself. I'm a friendly person. I like to spread positive energy wherever I go. I like each interaction with me to be pleasant because it's not what you said, it's how you make someone feel. I'm a great mom and I'm a great wife. All right. Good morning. I don't have a name. Yes. There we go. Now he's saying hi. So, I'm on a quick little break. Oh, it's not gonna work. I'm on a quick break from training. Ooh, I'm out of breath from coming up the stairs. We came upstairs to see what's going on up here. You see the snow? I feel like I'm breathing so hard. It's snowing outside. And I got off work this morning, but I had an opportunity to take a training class. It's only for a couple of hours, so I said, why not? So that's what I'm downstairs doing. Leno's working. Ameer is just kind of hanging out between the both of us. He was on the iPad. He was doing some coloring. I'm taking these braids out today. I know it has been entirely too long. Like, this is insane. I always leave my braids in for, like, a really long time because I just never feel like taking it down, number one. And it just be convenient. And half the time, I just be in the house anyway. I don't go anywhere. I don't do much of anything. So, but I have to take these braids out today. Like, it itches really bad. And it looks bad. So, hair's coming out today. I'm only on a quick 10-minute break. So, we just came upstairs to get some light because we're in the basement. And it's kind of dark down there. It's not really a lot of natural light. So, we're about to head back downstairs. He needs to get his hair washed today, too. The kids, why am I so out of breath? Did we breath? Oh, I carried Ameer up the stairs. That's why. His butt's heavy. the kids finally had school today. They've been out of school the last 2 days. Let me see, today's Thursday. So Monday was MLK Day. They didn't have school. And then Tuesday, they didn't have school. Or no, they did have school Tuesday. No, wait, today's Thursday. I'm confused. So they had school. They didn't have school Monday. They had school Tuesday. They didn't have school Wednesday. So they only didn't have school one day. I guess. Okay. I don't know. Whatever. Either way, they got school today. They're in school. I don't know if they're going to have school tomorrow because it's snowing again. So, we'll see. But I feel like my 10 minutes is probably up. So, we're about to find a snack. And then we're going to head back downstairs. And then I'll probably come back when I take my hair down or something. I don't know. Say, see you later, Ameer. Bye. You about to make us some breakfast? Just clean it up, honey. So, training is over. That's too low. You cannot see me down there. Where can I put you? So, training is over. Elena is still downstairs working. Ameer and I came upstairs. I'm hungry. He's playing with Frosted Flakes. What are we gonna eat? We need to do something to our hair, Amir. We look crazy right now. What do you want to eat? He calls food yummy. Amir, what kind of yummy do you want? Are you hungry?
Daddy.
Hmm?
Daddy.
I know, but what kind of yummy do you want? You want to make a sandwich?
Yummy.
Dang, Daddy bought a bunch of juice. This looks healthy. I told Lena we needed some juice. It's like 5 of these. With some V8 Splash down here. Those look good. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh! It's
6. Whoa! Whew. Alright, so I think I'm about to make. Do you want noodles? This is what Amir is saying to me. This is what you want? I think you had noodles last night. Let's have something else.
Hey.
Alright, so I think I'm about to just make a sandwich. And then I'm going to sit down for a minute because I literally got off work and went straight to the training class. And I'm about to feed my son and I. Then I'll start taking my hair. Now, what are you reaching for? You really want these noodles, huh? He's trying to get a bowl. Come here. I guess he really wants noodles. So, what are you guys eating today?
No.
Do y'all like pretzels? I was trying to find an alternative to like chips, like regular hot Cheetos and stuff like that. I guess this isn't too much of a difference because it has like a lot of salt.
This.
Want one?
No.
This. Alright, so Pop-Tart. This. No, he wants a Pop-Tart. We really need to get some kind of order because we just want everything. And Pop-Tart. Alright. Feed Amir and myself. Check on Lano. He'll probably be hungry in a minute. Sit down for a minute. I've been rewatching Hit the Floor. So I'm about to watch a little bit of that while I eat my lunch. And then the braids are coming down. I promise I'm taking the braids out today. There's no way I can go another day with these braids in my hair. I cannot do that. So I will be back. Said we'll be back. Bye. So I'm about to get ready to take Amir to the doctor. Look how he's looking at me. He is not a fan. I'm trying to just throw his hair in just a quick ponytail. He's gonna have his hat on. I'm gonna be in and out the doctor, hopefully, so I'm not about to try to do his hair. He's not feeling good. He is like giving me the death stare right now. Ameer, can you let me put your hair in a ponytail so we can go to the doctor? Please? Come on. Come on. Please? Come on. I'm trying not to get him all worked up because Leno is working and I have a headache and I really just don't feel like all of that right now. So sometimes in life you gotta pick your battles. And this is a battle that I just really don't have the energy to fight right now. So I'm gonna try a little bit more, spray some water on it, try to soften it up a little bit, throw it in a ponytail. If not, he just gonna go to the doctor with his hair looking crazy because I can't right now. You want to talk to the camera? You want to say hi? No? You got an attitude right now? These toddlers, boy, I tell you. He got his little snacks. Got some goldfish. Whoops. Some goldfish and a graham cracker. I got the iPad. But he just still not having it. I still need to get some clothes on. I'm like moving in such slow motion right now. But my head hurts. I need to go take something. But like I said, that snow was supposed to come later, so I need to get out here before the snow comes. I hate driving in snow, so, and I still need to go to the grocery store. So it looks like you're just gonna have to wear a hat, buddy. Okay? All right.
You okay now? Say hi. You say hi? Ameer. Wow. All right, he managed to let me do it. Yeah, you playing a game? Alright, now for myself to get ready.
Alright, we are finally in the car.
Ready?
I'm ready, baby. You ready?
Ready.
We ready. We're finally in the car.
Ready.
You said you ready? You not ready?
Ready.
You just said you was ready. Alright, we headed to the car. No, we are in the car, finally headed to the doctor. It's 12:40. They said that his doctor, we don't have to make an appointment, you can just be a walk-in, and they get out of lunch at 1 o'clock. So as soon as we get there, they'll probably be getting back from lunch. Hopefully there's nobody there and we can get in and get out. Ouch. Ow. I'm okay. Hopefully we can get in and get out because I'm not, again, me, I've gotten into a few accidents before. So when it comes to snow and rain, rather I'm driving in it, riding in it, I am just not a fan. So they said that the snow is supposed to start anytime after 2. Well, it's 1 o'clock now and we're just now headed to the doctor. And I got other stuff that I need to do. So my plan of not wanting to be in it so far is kind of I'm playing with fire here. So I'm gonna go to the doctor. I need to go to the beauty supply store because Ameer knocked my nose ring out. Well, he didn't knock it out. He was sleeping and he likes to sleep on my chest. I know he's gonna be 3 and he still likes to sleep on my chest with his hand in my shirt, and I let him do it. So anyway, I say that to say he was sleeping and his hair, because he was so close to me, his hair got caught on my nose ring and he went to like turn his head and he yanked it out. And this was like in the middle of the night, so I thought my nose was gonna be bleeding, because that's how hard it felt like he pulled it out. And though I've had my nose, oh, I forgot to put my earrings in. Though I've had my nose pierced for some time now, I still don't want to risk it closing up, even though I'm sure it's not going to close anytime soon, but I just need to get something back in there. So I need to go to the beauty supply store, find me a quick little, whoa, you're sliding. Find me a quick little, replacement nose ring. And then I need to go to Dollar Tree. I need to go to the grocery store. I kind of want to go to Best Buy, but I'm probably not going to be able to fit that inside. So, me and Ameer will check in with you later, Gator. Say, see you later, alligator. No, that's too much for you right now, probably, so. Pretty sure it is. Say bye-bye. All right, bye.
Well, Mr. Covington here has an ear infection in his, I think she said it was his right ear. So we're just waiting on her to bring us back his prescription. And then we have to go and get some blood work done. And then he has to see the asthma specialist in February. We got crusty lips. We need to put something on those lips. Let me see. Ameer. How you feeling, buddy? You okay? Say hi. So, bye-bye. So yeah, that's what we're doing now. Just waiting on her to come home. That's the prescriptions. And then we're gonna go get his lab work done. And then we're gonna run our other errands. So we'll be back. Say we'll be back. Say bye bye. I know. I still got these braids in my hair. I know. I'm still gonna take them out. I just got caught up. Pour me a little drink. I'm watching Hit the Floor. And I'm supposed to be taking them out while watching Hit the Floor, but really, it ain't no but, y'all. I just really don't feel like doing it. That's just what it is. I just don't feel like doing it. And it's supposed to be dry January. My January's wet. But no, seriously, I told myself that I'm not being hard on myself. Okay. So, a few things. First of all, my battery died.
And I was in the middle of saying that I'm giving myself grace. I know that's like a popular saying these days, but it's true for me. I was saying that I wanted to have a dry January, but I'm having a drink today. I'm off today. I'm off tomorrow. It's snowing outside. It's been a very long week, and I wanted to have a drink, so I did. When I say I'm not going to be so hard on myself, I'm not saying that I'm not going to be disciplined or I'm not going to follow through with what I say I want to do. I'm saying that a day like today, when I decided that I'm going to take a pause from dry January and have a drink, I'm not going to wake up tomorrow feeling guilty, or I'm not going to go to bed tonight feeling guilty. Like, I'm still following through with what I said. That doesn't mean that I'm going to just get drunk all weekend, or for the rest of the month, I'm just going to not do it anymore. That just means today I decided to take a break, have a drink, and that's okay. Secondly, I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to record while it's charging, but it's letting me record, so I don't know if it stopped charging or if both is just happening right now. Hopefully, both is just happening right now. So Leno went to go get Jordan and Blake. Jordan had tutoring today. He's getting both of them. I think he has an errand or two to run. Ameer is upstairs in his room, hopefully taking a nap, because that's what he's supposed to be doing. He wasn't asleep when I left out the room. I don't care. Take a nap. It's already late nap time, so figure it out. What else was I going to say? I recorded a clip of some groceries that I'm going to insert now. Okay, I just had to get a quick video clip. Ameer, stop. I just had to get a quick video clip of this real quick. I'm gonna explain more in a second, but you see we have two breads here, which we've already started to use one. We have double taco seasonings, double ranch, and double oranges. Should be five items. 1, 2, 3, 4. What was the other item? We were missing five.
Is it one in the Bible?
Maybe it was four. What was the other item? Well, I'm missing something. Either way, that's not the point. But just keep in mind that we have two of everything, and I'll explain more in the following clip. The donuts was the second item. Not that that was important, but I just wanted to come back because I knew it was five items. So the bread, the donuts, the taco seasoning, the ranch, and the halo oranges. So five items, which we have a double of, and I will explain more in a minute. What happened was, I'm running low. I need to refill it in a minute. But basically what happened was, yesterday I ordered DoorDash. I've actually never ordered DoorDash. What's it called? I did Instacart. Now, Meijer normally is my go-to, but I really wanted these specific donuts. So I ordered Instacart through Kroger, because Kroger is the only place that I know how to donuts. Yoshi, please don't lick yourself in the middle while I'm trying to record this. Or go somewhere else and do that, please. Nobody wants to hear that. So, okay, let me wrap this up. So I ordered from Kroger. Long story short, the guy, like, literally he replaced everything on the list. I had a total of 19 or 20 items. He replaced like 7 of the items, which I'm not saying it was his fault. Maybe they really didn't have those items. Okay, replace it, that's fine. But every time I got the notification that something needed to be replaced, I was like, oh my gosh, like, are you even trying? Or is it just easier for the replacement? Okay, whatever, I dealt with it. He pulls up to the house, and I notice that I have a bag of onions and I have a bag of potatoes, which I did not order. So my neighbor just so happened to be outside, and I'm like trying to flag the guy down. So he was able to like stand in front of the car to like flag the guy down before he drove off. I'm like, hey, these items aren't mine. Now, granted, I could have just kept the items, free onions, free potatoes. I'm not like that. I'm an honest person. I know I didn't order it. It's a snowstorm. I don't know. Maybe they're making soup for dinner and they really need these items. It's not mine. So I'm going to be honest and say it's not mine. Okay. Flag the guy down. He comes back. He takes the items. As I'm going through the bags, I'm like, okay, these grapes are not mine. These cucumbers are not mine. This tomato is not mine. Like, what the heck? Like, did he just give me all of the wrong things? So I started looking and I noticed I'm missing. Not only do I have somebody else's stuff, I'm missing half of my stuff. So I sent him a message through the app like, hey, now I missed some items and I also still have items that's not mine. He said, okay, no worries. This next order is around the corner. I'll be back. I'm thinking he's going to come back before he takes the groceries to the next lady because the common sense. And you can easily just go through the pictures and see what's mine and what's not mine. Okay, fast forward. He tells me, hey, the lady says that she didn't get the wrong stuff. Everything in her order is correct. So I'm just going to go back to the store and get the things that you're missing. Now, I was missing all of the things that you saw in the clip before this. The oranges, the ranch, the donuts. I was missing all of that stuff. It was a total of 5 items. She was only missing, at this point, the tomato, like 1 tomato, 2 cucumbers, and a bag of grapes. And they were soft. Like, it's a nasty batch of grapes. It's not even a good kind of grapes. So she was only missing those 3 items because I had already gave the onions and the potatoes. So I'm like, that's not a fair trade. Like, granted, I could use the tomato. I could use the cucumber. But that's not, I already have that stuff in my refrigerator. And I know I'm going to have to throw it out because now we have like an overload of cucumbers. We eat them, but not that much. Like, no, that's not a fair trade. So I text the guy, which I'll insert that clip here. So I text the guy and I'm like, she know dang well that stuff is not hers. He's like, okay, maybe she need it. Now, normally I will respond with, yeah, maybe she does. But I need it myself too. So I just didn't even acknowledge that. So he's like, okay, well, I'll bring it back. So he proceeds to send me his personal number, which, as you can see, that was like an iPhone text message. We're no longer texting in an app at this point. We're texting in the, like, regularly. So he's like, just send me what you're missing. I'll go back. So I don't know how Instacart works, but I'm going, how, I don't, let me slow down. I don't know how Instacart works. So I'm like, well, how are you going to go back? Like, I'm not going to pay for it again. I'm not going to send you more money. Like, are you just going to be nice and pay for it out of your money? Like, I don't know. I still don't know how that works. Like, are you just going to go back and just buy the items that I'm missing and give it to me? Whatever. So I'm like, okay, should I trust that he's going to come back with these items or should I report it missing? That way I can secure my money because they'll refund it. And they'll secure my money and refund it and then I can, like, just do another order. Or should I trust this guy and really know that he's going to come back with this stuff? So I'm like, well, I'm not in a position to chance it. So at this point, I just need to report it and, like, do it over. And, like, he never responded once I sent him, like, what I was missing. Like, he just stopped responding. So I'm like, okay, whatever. I'm going to just report it. So I did it earlier in the day because it's snowing outside. Like, the kids don't have school. I'm not trying to be waiting on these groceries all day. So I did it early enough so that I can get the items early enough. Okay, so long story short, well, actually, it's not a long story short because I'm telling the long version of it. Why do we say that and then we still tell the whole story? So I end up just reordering it. And then, y'all, I text the lady. Like, she's like, hi, my name's Ashley. I'll be, like, doing your order, whatever. So I'm like, Ashley, come, girl, please don't mess this up. This is my second time doing this. I'm already in a bad mood. I forgot. Why was I in a bad mood yesterday? I don't remember. Oh, the kids was getting on my nerves because they was at school. They was getting on my nerves yesterday. So I was kind of irritated. So I'm like, homegirl, please don't mess this up. Your homeboy already messed this up. Like, I'm going to need my groceries. She's like, don't worry, girl. I got you. So I just reordered it. But I was mad because Instacart only refunded the total amount of my groceries. They didn't give me the service fee or the tip or the delivery fee. So I still had to come out of money, which luckily I have it. But, like, what if I didn't have it? Now I'm without groceries, can't pay the delivery. Like, I feel like if they're going to refund it, they need to, like, include the whole thing. So she ends up bringing me the stuff. So the guy texts me hours later Like, at this point, I just knew he wasn't coming back. Like, I just put him out of my mind. Homegirl bought me my stuff. Everybody's happy. Except for a little piece of me that had to pay the extra money. But whatever. So, he texts me, like, hey, sorry. I'm headed back your way. But I did have to replace the taco seasoning and something. I think I screenshotted that, too. If I did, I'll insert that here. So, he's like, yeah, I just had to replace this, but I'm headed back your way. I'm like, should I tell him that I already got it? Or, like, what do I do? So, I just didn't say nothing. I just ghosted him the way he ghosted me because I didn't know what to do. So, next thing you know, I get a notification from the doorbell camera that he's outside. I'm like, wow, this guy really brought the stuff back. Okay, cool. So, he brings the stuff back, y'all. Now, mind you, I got the stuff originally from Kroger. He brings the stuff back. I check the bag. First of all, it's an Aldi bag. So, he just bought the stuff from Aldi. No big deal. I don't care. Maybe he, like, just took another Instacart order and just did it all there. Y'all, why I check the bag and the only thing in the bag is bread and donuts? So I'm like, well, luckily I did reorder it because you still only brought me half the dang on stuff. So then at this point, I'm like, okay, whatever. We got extra donuts. We got extra bed. Like, everybody loves donuts, which we none of us need, but whatever. And we go through bread like crazy. So cool. So I had to go to work last night. So I'm asleep. I wake up at like literally midnight because I put my phone on do not disturb. I wake up around midnight. I have a text message from him 3 hours, y'all. 3 hours after, yo, she stopped. 3 hours after he delivered the bread and the donuts, saying, "Oops, my bad, Yoshi. Oops, my bad. Your Yoshi, stop it. Oops, my bad. Your oranges and your whatever was missing, your oranges and your ranch or whatever, is on the door." So this man came back a third time with the other half of the order. I'm like, I didn't report. Yoshi, you better get kicked out of here. I didn't report this man. Well, I didn't report him, but I reported the stuff missing. So I know that's going to like affect his Instacart stars or whatever. And he done made 3 trips to my house. Now, I didn't feel... I don't know if y'all can hear him in the background, but he is scratching his carpet like crazy. Can you please stop? He's trying to get cozy and take a nap. So I did feel bad, but it's like, well, you messed it up in the beginning. So, I mean, it's not really my fault, but I did feel bad because, like, he was an honest, trustworthy person. You know what? I wonder if I can go back and, like, up his tip. Is that possible? I'm gonna look on there after I'm done recording this. I'm gonna tip him some more because granted he messed up originally, but he corrected it. This man came back 3 times. Well, twice. One was the original trip and he came back twice after that. I don't know. Should I up the tip or should I just let it go? Because like, how did you keep messing up? But he tried to make it better. So anyway, I say that to say favor. 1 second, my husband's calling. Sorry, husband was calling. Had to see, make sure everything was cool with him. But basically, I was just saying, like, God's favor. Like, I feel like I basically paid the price of one thing plus, the price of one grocery round. What am I trying to say? Basically, like I had, like I said, 19 or 20 items. I think it was 19 items and I paid for that. But then they refunded the money because I didn't get the items. So I had paid for them again with homegirl, but I paid for it out of the refunded money. So really it just canceled each other out. And then he brought me the items back. So really I got those set of items for free. Or for like half, it's a net, I'm sorry. Or for like half, because I still had to pay for the delivery fee and the service fee, and plus the tip, which came to like $12. So basically, I feel like I won because, like, the lady who refused to, like, swap out the items, yeah, she got my items, but I got double, and they were, like, not quality items. Like, nothing was really healthy in that batch of items, but you get what I mean? Like, I was, like, complaining and in a bad mood and was like, oh, my God, like, my order's messed up. It's such an inconvenience. Now I'm getting everything later. I'm going to have to cook later, blah, 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 blah. But not only did I get the exact items that I wanted, I got double that, and I didn't have to pay double. And homeboy really, like, went out of his way. So I don't know if I can go back and tip. And I'm still conflicted because it's like, you the one that messed up. Like, I don't know if he was rushing. But also the fact that he, like, really went out of his way to correct it. I don't know if I can sit, but I just pray that God covers him. And, like, he had a good heart, and people just do people so dirty and bold. Like, I didn't know if I could trust that he was going to come back, but he came back. He corrected the mistake twice. So I pray that God covers him in his Instacart journey. Hopefully he gets, like, a really big tip from somebody else. I'm gonna go back and see what I can do. I'm not gonna wish any bad on the lady who was dishonest. And he said, like, she stays literally, like, around the corner from me. Like, I don't know if I know her. Well, I don't know anybody that stays around the block. But he said she literally stays around the corner. So I'm not going to wish any bad on her. But it's like, you know you were dishonest. You know those weren't your items. And maybe she did need them more than me. So if that's the case, I'm glad that I was able to bless her with those items. So that's what happened yesterday with my Instacart story. It is now 10 minutes after 4, and I still have not taken my hair down. I don't know what clip is going to be first. I think I started off recording this morning when I had my training, my work training, and that was right when I got off work at 8:30 a.m. It is now 4 o'clock p.m., and I have not taken out not one single braid. Ugh. Okay, so I'm about to go cook dinner now because the kids and Leno are going to walk back in soon. So let me just cook dinner now. That way I won't have to stop. Cook dinner, take down my hair, and then we'll see what the night brings. So I'm probably not going to record anymore. You know what? Yes, I am. Once I finally do take my hair down, I'm going to record once my hair is down, and I'm going to record the time so y'all can know that I really did take these braids out. So thanks for watching. I normally don't close out these vlogs, but I don't know if I'm going to record anymore today because I just kind of want to enjoy the day with the kids. So I take my hair down. So if this is the end, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, let's engage, give me topics, let me know what you think. Like, talk to me. We homegirls and homeboys. Maybe that's what I can call y'all. Maybe I can be like, homegirl, let me tell you what happened today. Homeboy. You know what? I think that's what we just came up with. Okay. Homegirl, homeboy. I'll see y'all later. Maybe I'll record when the kids get home. If not, see you in the next video. Bye. Be with that girl, but that one ain't for me. She's fine as hell, but she'll always be with that girl. Nothing more than that girl. No matter what she do, she just can't be you, baby. Share your flaws with me, let me know. 'Cause I'm 7:20. Wait a minute. You can't see the time. Why can't you see the time? 7:20. Still have braids. Maybe we'll try it tomorrow.